is Fox 59 First at 4.
One person is dead after a shooting on Indy's near north side. It happened at the intersection of 30th and Capitol, just a block away from the Children's Museum.
It's an area heavily patrolled by Indy's 10-point coalition, but people who live there say it still has problems with drugs and violence. It is our top story, First at 4 on this Friday. Good afternoon to you. I'm Daniel Miller.
And I'm Birshel Edmay. Thanks for joining us here. Fox 59's Jesse Wells takes us to that intersection to explain what's being done to keep this community safe.
The deadly shooting right here this morning marked the fourth killing in exactly 2 years within just a few feet of 30th and Capitol. Unfortunately, all four of those murders remain unsolved.
While driving down Capitol Avenue in a black SUV, a woman was shot to death just after 4 o'clock in the morning.
I think it's unsettling and it's just not safe.
Jewel Vaden's family has run a daycare on Capitol for decades. She's seen a string of violence on the street, and she's tired of it.
I want something to be done to make it safer in this neighborhood.
Last August, 30-year-old Cameron Dixon was shot to death inside a car in the parking lot of a liquor store at 30th and Capitol. A few weeks later, 38-year-old Randy Abram was found shot to death in a nearby alley. And 2 years ago to the day, July 30th, 2019, in a backyard of an adjacent home, 44-year-old Robert Sanders was gunned down.
We know this is a problem area, so we gotta bring even more resources to try to fix it.
The Crown Hill neighborhood along Capitol has been patrolled by the 10-point coalition for years. Reverend Charles Harrison insists overnight drug dealing in the alleys on both sides of the street remains the main cause of the violence.
The drug trafficking that takes place on the corner of 30th and Capitol, in the alleyways on both sides, that has been a major problem.
While the motive for the overnight homicide remains unclear, Harrison believes cracking down on the drug dealing is the best way to stop the killing, and Jewel agrees.
I cannot stress it enough. It's got to be something done.
We have to identify the people that are selling the drugs and a part of the drug trafficking. We got to get them off the street, out of these neighborhoods.
Because no arrests have been made in any of the four homicides, anyone with information on those cases is still asked to contact Crime Stoppers. Jesse Wells, Fox 59 News.